Together.
And just like that, with the end of that story from the illustrious Moses, we're going to go right into the knife round here. C9, that's nothing. Freakazoid, Shroud, Skadoodle, and Sean Garris. They kept the at least three out of the four S's that they used to have. Freakazoid and Schnothing. And Fruit just runs up mid and shanks Sean Garris. Now they're going to go for the tag team action. Skadoodle finally going to get in the action, and Nothing's going to go down. Polly picking up that one. Oh man, not looking good for C9. I don't think they've won a knife round in the past 70 games they've played.
70, huh?
I'm sure Rotoderp has a statistic on that.
Well, here's the tough part. Here's what's kind of scary. And, you know, I don't think Cloud9's feeling any pressure whatsoever, but with their struggles on this map, starting Terracite is like the worst thing in the world for them. So here's a good opportunity for mouseSpaz to get off to a hot start and have a good first half.
Absolutely. So once again, you guys, mouseSpaz is going to be on the CT side. That's Fruit, Imsta, Zek, Demise, and Polly. And then the Cloud9 side, Sean Garris, Skadoodle, Shroud, Freakazoid, and Nothing. And let's see what they've got for us here in the pistol round. Why don't you take us away, Moses? I've been really enjoying your play-by-play this evening.
Alrighty. Let's do it. Another, actually, you see a lot of these new move-ups and these teams that were in Premier last season doing stacks on pistol round. That's just kind of a product, and you actually see two players rushing down mid as well. So it's just Sean spotting this out. Four teammates come around, but they don't actually clear mid. Sean called it out. Demise! What a round out of Demise. Three quick headshots for him. Runs out of bullets, but the damage is done. Fruit and Zek. Absolutely insane round from Demise there. Bailing him out in miscommunication, because you know Sean called it out. I don't know why no one was looking that way.
Wow. I mean, I don't know what to say. That was lightning fast. Three big frags. I mean, I thought he was going to get caught with his back turn from the alt mid push that was coming from C9, but he spins around and takes down three of them. What a huge round there to start things off from Demise. And look at that. Three FAMAS is already in play here for the CT side. And they're going to go for some Tech 9s here on the terrorist side. A couple of P250s to boot. And we're going to see if they can get anything going on their eco round here from C9. But what a great start for mouseSpaz.
Yeah, that should have never happened, though, and that's just, I'm just baffled why no one was looking that way, because Sean spotted that so early. He got a lot of shots off, and now we're going to see an armor buyout. Polly's going to take out Nothing with a headshot, so they have a nice advantage, 5-on-4 here. Sean forgoing armor for utility today. Kind of looks like they want to do some sort of delayed A execute. That's where Sean is. He's over in the halls.
But a nice spray down there from Polly through the smoke takes down Nothing at the beginning of this round, and that's definitely a good start. And look at how they turtled up here in the B bomb site, like we talked about before. Imsta and also Polly going to be over there, and they smoke the top side of Banana. So that push is going to be coming towards A. Freakazoid at the point spots out the shoulder of Zek. They're going to go on the hunt now. Flashbangs around the corner. They're going to try to peek this one out. He spots the shoulder, takes him down, but there's another one over there by Mono, and that's going to be Demise, who sprays down too. But now, just like that, that's going to leave Imsta, I believe, all by his lonesome. No, pardon me. That's Fruit over there in the pit, spamming away with that MP7, not able to locate the frags just yet. Freakazoid down to 20, Shroud down to 70. Now he's going to go ahead and peek out and Shroud. Oh, he can't get the shots off. He's getting blocked by that wood beam there. So the recovery here from the CT side, not too bad. Down to two players on both sides, Polly and Imsta, facing off against Shroud and Freakazoid. Combined 56 HP for the terrorist side. Yet to get that bomb planted. They haven't even recovered it just yet. 10 seconds on the clock. Imsta's put himself into a really good position here, and Freakazoid's going to go ahead and try to hold this bomb site. But coming around the corner now, they're going to spot him out. And simultaneously, they both go down. Polly and Imsta clean it up. Imsta almost does fall there to a nice headshot dink from Freakazoid, but not able to get that round. And that's going to be mouseSpaz salvaging it 2-0.
Yeah, salvaging it, but three players down, the bomb gets planted. That's a huge win for Cloud9 there, and I'm actually kind of surprised that in that 2-on-2, the mouseSpaz players didn't group up over towards the rap side and protect the bomb. Don't let them get the bomb. They let them get away for scot-free. Polly in a 1-on-2 is a little bit too scared to take the fight, which is smart, but you know, letting him get the plant like that, letting the bomb get away, a little bit brutal. So a huge eco round for Cloud9.
All right, well, they have upgraded a couple of rifles here, and Fruit with a nice nade down mid's going to be able to find the first one, and that's going to be Freakazoid down and out. And look at this aggression coming now from the CT side. Imsta's already down in the cubby at the bottom side of mid, or bottom side of Banana, pardon me. He's going to pop flash out for his teammate Polly to go around the corner, and he's going to peek on out, and he's going to be able to catch Skadoodle. No! Completely denied, but Imsta's there for the trade and going to be able to find one, and now pushing up around the smoke is going to be Nothing. Pops a shot, does a little bit of damage, picks up the M4. What a smart play from Nothing. Never short of amazing from him.
This is just really weird aggression from mouseSpaz, though. Like, why are they pushed like that on a Nika run? There's no armor on the side of Cloud9. I'm not giving a Colt over to Nothing. It's down to a 3-on-3. Look at how spread out the defense is. One in A, you know, Zek is in library, not sure where he wants to go, and one over towards B, and it's going to be a 3-on-1 here at this bomb site. Here comes the smoke into CT spawn, and Fruit has a lot of work to do.
Absolutely, but again, that smoke over in CT spawn, Zek's got no line of sight here, and Fruit trying to hold on here, but Sean Garris comes around, he is able to clean that one up. But nothing with an M4 that he salvaged. Picks up another one. That's two big frags for him. And now Zek around the corner is going to find the headshot. Can he take down the last one? No. Shroud now in a 1v1. He did pick up that M4 off of nothing. So they've been trading it around the entire time. And now he's going to get spotted out. Knows that he's over by Nubox. And Demise. Nice shot through the crack. Takes down Shroud. Getting a little too aggressive for his own good there. We're going to see mouseSpaz picking it up. But another good eco round there from C9.
Not even good. Great. Four kills, bomb planted again. I mean, this is brutal for mouseSpaz. So, yeah, they're up 3-0. Good start, but this is... that's harsh. It's very harsh in their economy. Now you look at Cloud9, pretty much everyone at 6 grand, Sean at 5 grand, you know, buying some utility on those eco rounds. And, I mean, mouseSpaz, this is a round if they lose, they're on a save just because of how much damage they've taken. They're going to have a good buy here, but no economy behind it whatsoever.
And there it is, Skadoodle picking up the AWP to start things off in the first gun round, and we're going to see where he decides to go with that. As I'm going to follow in his eyes, it looks like he's going to go for a mid pick here. And surely nobody from mouseSpaz is going to tempt the fates with an early pick down mid, and rightfully so. But look at this Freakazoid in his usual spot, trying to get that banana control, and look at this, we've got mouseSpaz taking a leaf out of the Luminosity gaming book here, except that Imsta is going to be in front of the sandbags instead of behind it. Freakazoid down there by the wood chips.
Yeah, and you're going to see a lot of that this half. He loves this battle over at B. And that's such a crucial player to have as an entry fragger, someone who likes this battle.
And again, Zek going to go ahead and smoke off the top side of the banana hallway. So they're using their nades properly here on the mouseSpaz side, and it looks like Skadoodle is going to work that up towards mid, but Polly just full aggression. Look at that peek, and he finds two from it. Great awareness from him. He catches Skadoodle looking the wrong way, and Shroud's not there for the trade. And just like
yeah, Shroud that. Shroud had a smoke out, and that was actually, that's that teamwork I'm talking about. That was a nice pop flash peek from them.
So a great start to the rifle round here from the mouseSpaz side, and Polly rotates back around to join Imsta over there at the B bomb site, but he's going to be on a trek back towards A, and that's exactly where they're up by slots now, talking about C9, and going to go ahead and pick up that bomb and Freakazoid. Sean Garris going to open things up, smart, though. Nice shot from him. But it gets too aggressive. The trade is there, though. Freakazoid's going to find one. He's going to look for a second one in the site. He's going to be able to find it. So now down to a 2v2, and the HP value is relatively equal across the board for both sides. But now what's C9 got? They're both stuck in the bomb site here. And Freakazoid, that's a great pop flash. Catches Imsta completely unawares. But peeking out now, he's going to find one. Freakazoid looking for the peek. Going to be able to find a third frag this round. And now Polly jumping around the site. Going to try a little bit of spam out. Can Polly do it down to a 1v1? Freakazoid on the other side of the pole. He's playing ring around the Rosie, and Freakazoid with a quad. Going to take him down, and C9 is on the board. Salvages the AWP as well. So that's Cloud9 getting that momentum back in their favor here, picking up the first gun round.
Yeah, the composure by Freakazoid in that situation was wonderful. Stuck inside the bombsite in that 1-on-2. He wins that one, but, you know, the real savior that round was Sean with that entry frag. They threw a Molotov at the pole, and he just pre-fires the side of the pole, you know, where that he's definitely going to force a counter-terrorist out of position, and he did exactly that and gets that kill with the pre-fire, so... This is where you see that eco, the economy game for mouseSpaz. They were so brutalized in the first three rounds that now they're forced to save immediately.
And Zek, he decided to go for a peek, and Shroud made him pay for it up there by Balcony. And Sean Garris, he's only got an SMG, but jumping headshot, he's going to find the double. And that's the B-bomb site completely open for business now. Demise and team going to be on that rotation back around. There's a gap in the smoke here, and nothing is going to be... poised on that position, finds one, tapping away with that AK, looking for a second one, but Freakazoid, no fear, pushes out, cleans up both of them, and that's going to be Cloud9 with a five-man stand in their second gun round here, and 3-2 is going to be your scoreline.
And it's going to have to be a double save out of mouseSpaz, it looks like. I mean, they could force up here in a Famas and maybe a shotgun, but that would be so risky early on in the half. That would have to pay dividends, or else this would be a brutal half for them, so they're going to save one more. Smart decision, probably get some armor. But it's looking like Cloud9 has a great shot at equalizing it up at 3-3 early on.
Right you are. And again, we've seen Skadoodle with that AWP, but he's been quiet. He's sitting at 1-4 right now, but I expect him to start picking up those frags. But right now it's Freakazoid 8-3, doubling up on the next teammate. And Fruit's going to get aggressive here by Balcony. He might be able to catch one off. Let's see this play unravel. Shroud's down underneath. Oh, he backs off just at the wrong time. I think Shroud might have had him dead to rights there as he backed out looking up at that balcony.
Yeah, he got spotted, I believe, because Shroud whipped up there pretty quick. Oh, I think his teammate over at Hull spotted him out. That's Sean. So, forces him back a little bit, and they're just doing a default standard setup here on the eco round, so not gambling whatsoever. Sean's being very cautious clearing out Hull's. And this is the difference we saw between Cloud9 and, you know, the move-ups. All this slow map control they have, but Zek with a nice shot is going to take out Freakazoid. There's an opening pick. Shroud's still stuck in mid, battling over towards Porch.
And Sean Garris peeking out an awkward angle for him, and Zek's going to pick up the double. So that bomb is going to get picked up by Skadoodle. They're going to work their way back towards the B bomb site, maybe think that they've got better luck over there. But this is a good-looking beginning to this eco round here for the CT side of mouseSpaz. Pop flash over the top. They're going to be able to spot one out by Spools. They've got one to beat by the fountain. Nothing finds one. Shroud with the second one, and that's all evened up now into a 3-3. But they have salvaged two AKs on Fruit and Zek. And Demai is going to push through the smoky spots. Nothing, I believe, that was up on top of the back boxes by Dark. It's going to lay a little bit of damage onto him. So, and there it is. Finally, Skadoodle getting that AWP to work. Going to be able to find one, but the push is coming from the seat, from the banana hallway. And Skadoodle is very, very low in that pre-fire. But, oh, nice shot from Skadoodle. Nothing going to clean up the last one, and they salvaged the round out. A close eco round and a good one from mouseSpaz.
Yeah, dealing some damage of their own, but now it begins, because Zek picks up that AWP. He's got a tall task against Skadoodle this entire map, so that'll be a matchup we'll have to look for. But Cloud9, this is scary, because even on the gun round they lost, they poly peaked mid and killed two of them immediately, so they've lost the early rounds. They're losing some of these early battles, even on that eco that last round, so that's going to be something they need to shore up moving forward into the gun rounds.
And they're going for aggression here at Banana, and Imsta, he's going to burn alive in that if he's not careful, but Freakazoid takes him down, does him the favor anyway. They went for the smoke at the bottom of Banana, but unfortunately it was off the mark, and Fruit's going to go aggressive here, and Sean Gary is going to save Shroud with a nice frag onto Fruit. So the 2-0 right now in favor of the terrorist side of Cloud9. Nothing going for mouseSpaz in this round. Zek picks up the AWP, but he's playing all the way from Moto, very passive angle there.
Yeah, and that's what Cloud9 wants to do. Freakazoid gets a pick over towards Banana. One player gets aggressive on the CT side, and Sean's able to just hold an angle and take him out. So quickly down to a 3-on-5, and now it's almost like mouseSpaz is forced to gamble. They need to get aggressive somewhere, grab information, and or gamble stack like they're doing over here at A, and just give up the B bomb site. And this will just be a save if they end up hitting B. So it's pretty much the A bomb site or bust for mouseSpaz at the moment.
And Shroud's actually on the lurk over here by A, trying to keep him honest. They're going to rotate the Poly over towards the B bomb site. That's where the hit's going, and if he gets there quickly, he might be able to stave this off, but they've smoked it off, and this should be the call for the save now from the CT side. You can see they're not really budging over here at this A bomb site, and Shroud's not going to get overly aggressive and lose his rifle, so it will be a three-man save round here for the CT side of mouseSpaz, so we will see Cloud9 picking up their first lead of the matchup at 4-3, seven rounds in.
I actually think Shroud should have tried to go for some kills there. I mean, look at his economy. Look at the economy of mouseSpaz. If he gets one or two kills, that would be huge. Because next round with three rifles, I mean, mouseSpaz can buy 2 5.7s and armors or two upgrade some pistols. And that's a pretty decent buy. They can do some damage with that.
Well, you saw the success they had on the last eco round with those pistols. So definitely not a bad call. And they go on the chase here. And Polly going to get the better of nothing here. And Zek finds Freakazoid, so they're doing a little economical damage. Polly's going to find another one as well. So
yeah,
losing
see,
three at the
that's
end.
That's the position. Like, Shroud had mid control. He had brackets, and he fell all the way back towards B, threw a gun up on the roof, and came back. But at that point, it allowed the mouseSpaz players to find those spots to just save their weapons and get those kills. So Shroud stays in that position. He might be able to kill one or you know, get traded off maybe, but he has the intel. He knows where to direct the rest of his teammates if they still want to go for the guns. There, they just give up three right at the end. So not that great of a decision by Cloud9, but not huge. They have four rounds of the terror sites. They're going well right at the moment. Polly's going to throw out a Molotov. He's going to be blinded, though, so they stop any kind of B aggression. Here they are set up. Freakazoid's going to lead the way. He gets another entry frag. He's going to throw a nade. He knows Imsa's there. Now Imsa's in a very, very tough spot. Nade lands on him, but Freakazoid's still coming. Skadoodle gets the nade. And that's the B defense cleared out. So another buy round, but B gets cleaned up by Freakazoid and Skadoodle's aggression.
And the pop flash from Fruit. It's off the mark, but he does clean up Sean Garris anyway, so an eye for an eye right there. But Zek, I'm going to be looking for one getting aggressive over there by the construction hallway. Not going to be able to line anything up as we follow in the eyes of Skadoodle. Looking for the CT spawn picks. He's not going to be able to locate anything as of right now. And these CTs, well, they're just looking to keep them honest here on the terrorist side. They're going to pop a couple of shots here. Trying to make something happen. And Demise tapping away with the M4 finds one. Actually dinks nothing as well. But nothing going to continue to get aggressive here. Zek's going to make him pay for that. So again, losing rifles in the late game on Cloud9 side after the post plant. But again, they're picking up the rounds, and that's all that matters. And that economy is not looking too bad for him. Skadoodle sitting over there with 9,900. He's going to be able to drop a teammate or two.
Yeah, the guns that they're losing here aren't really worth that much, so it's not a huge issue for them. They do take a Colt out of mouseSpaz's hand, so it's another round. They're going to have to drop a couple Colts to buy up here from Zek and Fruit, and they've got to find some of their composure back. They've got to start winning some of those early battles. In that first gun round that they actually lost, but it was great. They were patient, and then they did a pop flash teamwork play with Pauly. That's when he was able to get those two openings. They need to get back to that. Right now, they're just giving up too many early kills.
Right you are. So we're going to see if they can continue to chip away here, talking about the C9 side as we continue to move forward. And it looks like they're going to go for a relatively standard setup here on the terrorist side, but that AWP from Zek is right on Freakazoid's position, and he is going to get that opening pick. So the aggression for Freakazoid, well, maybe stick to Banana Buddy, because it's been working for him over there so far.
Yeah, now they're just playing Imsta, the two B players, Imsta and Pauly, playing passive behind the smoke. It's nothing's job, but it is down to that 4-on-5, so the AWP from Zek, he stays in middle, too. You oftentimes see an AWPer relocate a little bit more. He's going to get smoked off. Now he's got to find a new angle. But they do have a good situation. Cloud9 just playing a little bit slow, waiting for any kind of aggression, any kind of push from the counter-terrorist, and Skadoodle's going to shore up this mid.
And I'm not sure if you saw that, but that nade that bounced onto nothing's feet at Banana, that couldn't have been any more perfect. It was just one of those. It was one of those goofy ones that just the way nades bounce in this game,
magnetized.
It just sucked right onto his feet. Nevertheless, we are going to see the man advantage coming for the way of the CT side of mouseSpaz, and again, looking for these plays. And Sean Garris actually turning from a nade that was thrown in another direction, kind of weary of that mid presence, that mid push from Pauly from the last time, but. Now Fruit, he's going to bide his time and play this smart from the pit. He's going to lob a nade out, and he's actually going to spot Sean Garris getting aggressive over here. And Zek is going to capitalize. Fruit chimes in with another one. And now pushing around the corner, Zek is going to find a third. And can he get the last? No, Demise is going to clean that one up. So mouseSpaz showing a little bit of life here. A four-man stand that's good for the economy. And Zek putting $300 extra in the bank from that AWP round there. He's sitting at 10-5, so he's not doing too bad for his team. Imsta a little slow to start, but... they are chipping away, getting a couple of rounds here, and mouseSpaz, if they get two more, they've already beat my prediction.
Yeah, that's a really good defensive stand by them. They got the opening pick, and they just kind of turtled up into the site and played the advantage, and when that execute finally does come in, they had three players just aimed at that choke point, so they need to keep that up. They need to stop losing these early battles. Pauly's going to peek right into Freakazoid. Freakazoid jumping up, though. Can't win that one. He falls, so another man advantage. Zek chimes in as well. Down to a 4-on-3 once Skadoodle is done with his shot.
And Polly's still playing very aggressive over here, and Skadoodle lightning fast reflexes.
That's so unnecessary. Now they've just given up into a 3-on-3 with a minute and 15 left on the clock. Now Cloud9 can slow play this so effectively, and this defense is eventually just going to get spread out.
Yeah, and that's exactly what's happened. They're moving that bomb back towards the A bomb site, and the number four man, Demise, is already rotating over towards the B bomb site. They've thrown their smokes over. They've thrown the flashes over. They've showed their hand at B, but they're already rotating back towards A, and Fruit has got his hands full. Shroud coming around the corner. That's one. Can he pick up the last two? He's going to be able to pie in the second one. Can he get the third onto Skadoodle? He misses the AWP shot coming around the corner, but Skadoodle is going to be too quick for him, and now he's in a position where he's got to ace it out if he wants to win the round. Can Skadoodle do it? Can he go huge? He's already picked up three. Smokes off the truck side. He's going to have a clear line of sight onto Zek. Finds the frag. He's got one to beat. He spots him jumping over. Which way is he going to go? Misses the AWP shot. But he gets ace in the long run. Skadoodle going huge. That's exactly why they picked him up.
I mean, that's he's able to find those one-on-ones, smokes off the lane side, and he peers back around towards small pit, finds the one-on-one there, wins that battle, and the other counter-terrorist isn't aggressive enough. Either it wasn't communicated, but a little bit too exposed was the first member of that mouseSpaz retake, and Skadoodle comes up massive, and that's why he's the best.
Just flat out. But that's one of those plays where, you know, you saw the shot that he took on Pauly through the pillars. Not a necessary peak there, but that shot was still ridiculously quick, and, you know, the guy still got it. But again, showing his wits as well, smoking off the truck side, knew that they were coming from the split, and he's going to be at the point here. Going to pop a shot, and now the pop flash comes out, and Polly singling him out, but Freakazoid and Sean Garris are there for the trades. And that's going to be a two-man mowdown over there by the banana hallway, and that's going to be the opening that Cloud9 was looking for. So pushing down aggressively in mid, Shroud pop flashing over the top, going to spot out Zek, takes him down. Not much of a rebuttal from them. And now Nothing spraying through the smoke, finds one! That's Demise, what a shot from Nothing. They're going to continue to spray on through. And still chipping away onto Fruit. And there it is, Sean Garris finally able to lock it down. 7-4 now for Cloud9, and I'm still marveling at that round from Skadoodle, because like I was saying, throwing that smoke over by Truckside, delaying that push, able to neutralize the 1v1s, and that just shows you the analytical mind that he has on him as well. You know, just not just a great player, but also a great mind in the game. Pardon me, I'll stop fanboying here in a minute.
Oh, fanboy all you want.
He's good. Go for the gold. He's good, all right.
Oh, look at that flash. It unfortunately blinds Freakazoid as well, so trades go in the favor of mouseSpaz, but it's quickly equalized. But now there's a B push, and Nothing's onto it. He knows that's where the other push is going to be coming. He flashes and jumps across. Doesn't know how many are there, but look at Fruit playing behind the smoke, spamming through. That's going to be the indication for Shroud to get aggressive, thinking that reload was going to come in. But now they've made their way up Rapside, and they're going to find a one-on-one over here because Polly's rotating. Once again, this defense is split up. Imps is on a fast flank, so Cloud9 needs to be a little bit quick with this, and Polly might be able to find one or two. They're not looking. He's going to spray one down. He's going to spray a second one down. Sean gets the kill. He's going to grab the bomb. He's got a one-on-two of his own to win here.
We're going to see if he can do it. Imsta coming around the corner. He's playing right into Sean Garris' crosshairs here. Can he pick up this double and close the round out? Fruit over by Pitt. They've got a really good crossfire here from the mouseSpaz side. If he's able to negotiate his way in towards that area, he might be able to do something here. Fruit is going to spot him from the pit. Sean Garris is onto it. Flashbang comes out. Not going to be enough to blind him. Imsta running around mid, making a lot of noise. Yep. He's going to find the first. Can he get the second one? He's still got 28 seconds to play with. He's going to go ahead and plant that potato in the garden there at the A bomb site. And now Imsta, again, the smoke play. Drops the smoke, works his way around from behind it. This is a great play from Sean Garris. What's he got for us? One versus one against Imsta. He continues to play this. He has no idea that he's already made his way around the bomb site, so this could be Imsta in a 1v1. No, Sean Garris is going to win it. 3K of his own. Skadoodle, anything you can do, I can do better, and that it is Sean Garris winning that 1v2.
Yeah, and both of those clutch rounds from both Skadoodle and Sean, now they're finding these one-on-one battles, so getting into these two-on-one situations, mouseSpaz isn't able to communicate and get in the proper positions. And I mean, a nice shot on that player in pit. If Sean doesn't hit that shot, that round's lost. So great play from him in the game sense when he's in that bomb site with the smoke down, you know, counting the seconds, knowing if he's not jumping over that box or trying to come through that smoke, he might be coming around you at that point. He turns just at the right moment.
Fruit trying to get aggressive over there by balcony, and he eats a nade. Already down to 9 HP. That was damn near 100 damage nade right there. I shouldn't get excited about nades because a lot of the times the damage, well, you know, the early round damage can be a big factor, but with some of these players and their ability to frag out anyway, it doesn't really make too much of a difference, but that was a big nade. They've got a three-man stack at this B bomb site. That is exactly where they're attacking in Freakazoid, pardon me, gets dinked up real nicely. Demise playing behind Spools, and they're going to be able to find him out, but Imsta's now going to be over there, and they clear it out wholeheartedly, and that's going to leave Fruit with only 9 HP over in this A bomb site by his lonesome.
Yeah, patient. With the rounds that they've won, they're able to pick up these Molotovs on the T side, so you can see, even when they throw the smokes, but they don't just rush into the bomb site. They spot one out of triple, he dinks a teammate, and they just play it patient, and they Molotov him out, they force him out of position, and then they take the battles from there. So cleaning out spots on these entries very, very cautiously.
Absolutely. So, again, you can see Freakazoid top fragging, but the rest of them right in tow with them, with the exception of Shroud. And that's kind of the funny thing, is Shroud has been kind of their consistent top fragger over the last couple of matches that we've seen. But if he's able to sit back and relax, or if he's not required to frag out and the rest of his team can step it up, then that's kind of a good turning point for C9. And now we see Fruit actually aggressive over here in apartments. He's going to nuke a chicken with a flashbang, but he's going to be able to spray down two without any kind of a trade there. And Zek is going to find Skadoodle as well, so he wins the AWP battle there in mid. Down to a 5-on-2 already, only 10 seconds into the round.
Yeah, not much for Cloud9 for Sean, and Nothing to do here. So some good early aggression from mouseSpaz. Fruit gets those kills. Zek with the AWP chimes in. He's, you know, rounds where Zek's been able to pick one off, they've looked good going forward into the late round. It's It's just, you know, Sean talked about it. Yeah, I mentioned it before this cast. Sean said they wanted more late round players, and that's exactly what they've gotten. They've gotten some big time efforts, and there goes Sean. Nothing's in middle with an 80-50. He's going to get blind. Polly's going to take him out. And it looks like he's going to pick up that op, and this is actually a double op setup on Inferno. We don't see it too often, but for the last round, it might catch him off guard a little bit.
Yeah, absolutely. But they know that they salvaged that op. It looks like Polly's going to be the AWP-er that's going to pick that up. No, maybe it's going to be Fruit here. He buys a scout.
That was a misbuy.
I figured as much. They're still throwing guns around, Polly. What are they doing? Okay,
they didn't want the double op setup. They didn't want the double op setup on Inferno, so they were trying to swap guns around, and it was just a little bit confusing for them. And so you're going to see they're out of spawn a little bit late. That's going to force the aggression over towards B. It looked like one of the players wanted to get aggressive but couldn't do it. His teammate wasn't there, and probably smart. Cloud9's cleaning out sandbags very efficiently.
And now Nothing already spotted the AWP on the right side of mid, so Zek is going to be forced to resign his position over there at A, and Polly going to get aggressive again. He's taking some peeks out there, some wide peeks too, walk peeking it. Freakazoid not in a position to punish him for it just yet, but Skadoodle going to go ahead and drop a smoke grenade onto the left-hand side of middle, and they're going to make this press up towards A. Let's see if Zek and company can hang on to things here. Zek playing from the arches and CT spawn. Might be able to get a line off on the one or two players here with that AWP, at least get a lot of information for his team to rotate on out. Let's see what he's got here. They're going to make that pressure coming up, and they're going to be going around towards his side, and Freakazoid's going to be the first one over there. And he doesn't take the shot.
Yeah, now he's in a lot of trouble. He's going to get smoked up from Library and in Arches, so he's going to have a really tough time finding success. Actually, they don't smoke him off whatsoever. They flash, and they just jump across, but they get the kill anyway. Sean with an entry, Freak with the other one, and all of a sudden, it's just Fruit. Too much to do. He goes down to Skadoodle. A great execution from Cloud9. Everything looked perfect with a double setup and pit, and then all of a sudden, they just blow things up. So this last round, going to go in the favor of Cloud9. It's a 2-on-5. It would have to be an absolute miracle, but Sean's in a great position.
A rare miss from Skadoodle over towards Library, but gonna go ahead and peek out and takes down another one, and Sean Garris biding his time. 10-5 in favor of Cloud9 on their terrorist side, and that is a fantastic start for their matchup.
Yeah, but we've seen some struggles they've had on the CT side, and you know, these new pickups have looked good in that first half, and going forward we're gonna see what they have in store on the defensive side.
Absolutely, so just waiting for this one to live back up into the second half pistol round, and you know, basically pretty much to book the way that we thought that it was going to go. Maybe not that heavily in C9's favor on the T side, but their executions definitely looked like they were on point. So Sean Garris calling the audibles and making things happen for him in the late round, and some hero plays from Sean Garris himself and also Skadoodle to solidify that. And you can see the spread now. Shroud's still kind of quiet over there on the CT side of C9, but the rest of the team sitting at 12, 13, 13, and 10 respectively. So we'll see whether or not mouseSpaz can get anything going. They've kind of taken a page out of the Fnatic book there, dropping the Tech 9 onto Polly with the body armor. So we'll see if they can do anything over here towards the B-bomb site. They've got a three-man stack here from the CT side. They're going to smoke things out. Freakazoid going to come under contention, and that's going to leave Shroud with basically free reign. They haven't even spotted him. He's going to find one. Tapping away. Looking for a second. Not going to be able to find it. And that is going to open things up a little bit. A two-for-two over at that bomb site. Or, pardon me, a two-for-one. But Skadoodle and Sean Garris both very, very low.
Yeah, Shroud wanted to do way more damage, so it's going to be all up to Nothing's positioning, because they're going to come up mid-quick. He's the only one at this A site, and he's kind of stuck in no man's land. He's got... Oh, they don't actually go up. They bail him out. So Nothing, he was going to have to go huge there, but they fall right back, and at some point, Nothing's going to hear this, and he's more than likely going to start pushing and get some kind of information.
I would assume as much. Skadoodle joins him over there at the A bomb site, so they've got one low player at both bomb sites to contend with. It's going to be Sean Garris over by Spools. They molly things out, and Sean's going to be able to spot one. Still looking for it. A dink being dealt onto Demise. And still chipping away. Freakazoid 1-2. Last man standing. Going to be Fruit over here. He's pushing the smoke, trying to get Sean Garris down and out. He does manage to take him out. He's still got Freakazoid in the backside of that bombsite to contend with. Spamming through the smoke. He's going to find a little bit of damage onto him. 18 seconds left on the clock at this point. Maybe just save the armor and the Tech 9.
I know. I mean, it's a pistol. You go for it. He gets a nice shot there on a Nothing. Great double tap. Yeah, you're right. 8 seconds left. There's really not much you can do. You can't save it at this point, but not anything here to find. And Freakazoid comes up huge there with a 3-kill holding. Actually, a 4-kill in the round, but a 3-kill on that defense of the bomb site. So nicely done by him and Sean holding that off.
Skadoodle going right for the scout in the second round. We've seen it pretty prevalently over the past, picking up the scout for the second round by. Some SMGs as well. Some MP7s being purchased across the board for the remainder of his team, with the exception of nothing with that FAMAS in hand. It's going to be a no armor buy here from the terrorist side, so they must be thinking third round buy.
I mean, they bought some pistols, so they've lost a little bit of economy there, and they didn't get the bomb plant, so it would be a very sparse third round buy, but I mean, that they might just be saving up for the fourth round, to be completely honest with you, just full saving.
Sean Garris going to get aggressive down at the banana. Going to be able to find one, finds the second, finally does fall. Freakazoid's going to be there to take one down. Nothing falls as well. Shroud coming around the corner is going to find one, does a lot of damage onto Fruit, and now Freakazoid should be there for the cleanup. And there it is. Basically by the book, a three-man stand there. Some MP5s or MP7s, pardon me, MP5s. Yeah, I'm living in the past.
And I can't imagine mouseSpaz choosing to buy here, so this is going to be one more save from them. Interesting not seeing any kind of investment in that round. They did some decent damage even without anything, and if they had some of those pistols, they might have gotten a little bit more out of it, but they're going to drop some Tech 9, so they're going to upgrade those and get three smokes on their side, so interesting to see what they decide to do from that. It looks like they all five are going to want to go over towards this B site, take control, and then do a smoke execute with spindles, but these nades are going to come in. They got to be careful. That one doesn't deal nearly as much damage as it looked like it would have, and that's something we say about nades pretty much every time they're thrown.
Yeah, absolutely. So looks like they are going to go for that smoke strat, and Freakazoid is sitting by car right now, so he could have himself a day. Just waiting for that push to come out. Freakazoid spots one. Going to pop some shots, drops the flashbang out. That's going to stave off that push for just a little while longer. Sean Garris is going to be there to sweep one under the rug. They're going to get aggressive on him. They push through, and they do manage to take him down, but Shroudy's there, one and two. And now Fruit trying to plant, and Freakazoid denies him. So they went for the smoke plant at the B bomb site. Not a bad strategy there. They were able to pick off one, but not after the damage was done.
Yeah, Freakazoid, by the way, we haven't mentioned scores too much, having a great half, 20-11 for him, top ranking for his team. Those B entries he got, he just loves that banana. So those B entries he got, not only the frag count, but just opening things up for his team multiple times last half. He's been an absolute beast for him. So that pickup's looking very, very good in this opening match.
As we move forward into the fourth round of the second half, we're going to be seeing a full gun round now, and Skadoodle, he's going to go full aggression, and Demise going to pay.
And that's what Skadoodle duty is, so already a man advantage, and that's huge so early on in the round, and mouseSpaz has got to feel crappy about that one in disarray, but they equalize it. Sean gives one up, Fruit finds him, and that was actually through smoke. Sean was just trying to get to car.
Yeah, so good awareness from Fruit. They do move one more player over towards that B-bomb site. That's going to be Skadoodle with that AWP, so they got to be careful on the terrorist side. And still Freakazoid playing very aggressive behind this smoke. Finally lands from Skadoodle. Nade comes around the corner towards Sandbags. Not going to find any damage onto Freakazoid, and he's going to resign his position back into a more passive setup here at the B-bomb site. Still support from Skadoodle over by CT Spawn. Quick rotation from him.
No smoke on any of the Cloud9 players. They got two Molotovs. Freakazoid has one as well, but he's got to hold that until an execute comes in, and that could be dangerous if mouseSpaz decides to just walk up, and here comes a Molly, and there's Freakazoid picking it up. He's going to drop it off right at the base, but he's getting burned out. He's got to leave oranges. He doesn't see one in water already, who's completely blind, so he's got some time to work with, but he's going to get shot down here eventually, although he does manage to spray one down. That's the best thing he could have done there. 3-on-3 now. Skadoodle falls as well, so the bomb site, it goes in the way of mouseSpaz.
Nothing drops the Molotov out. The bomb does get planted, so a good recovery here so far for mouseSpaz, and let's see if they can hold on to this round in the late game. Is that going to be watching for that construction flank around? Going to be able to find a nice headshot onto Shroud. That's going to leave it all on nothing here with just a FAMAS in hand. He's trying to chip away on a Polly, but Polly's going to get the better of him with the Galil, and that's going to be mouseSpaz picking up the first gun round, so not a bad start for them on their terrorist side. They're able to get their sixth round on the board. It comes in a gun round, and that money situation not very good on the C9 side. Freakazoid 6,100, but Skadoodle and Sean Garris sub 3K, so not a great situation here for the Cloud9 side.
Yeah, and they might have been able to, you know, force up something a little bit crazy like we've seen Cloud9 do in the past, but seven rounds to work with. Whoopsie. They're going to have...
Dusty!
They have a lot of time to work with. They don't need to force anything, so they actually buy five smokes, and they're going to use those to try and funnel them over towards A, where they have a stack, and nothing has two pop flashes for his team as well.
All right, and Shroud's got the Desert Eagle in hand, the Blaze, and we'll see if he can light him up with that. Molotov off the mark into apartments.
You can see Skadoodle's trying to teach Freakazoid how to line up that smoke on the fly. So they're just going to... They have two to three players towards the wrap side, so they're going to continuously smoke off B from there. And they're going to use these pop flash to try and hit this execute as they funnel them towards A. Freakazoid gets an opening pick.
Yeah, and they've got four members close on this A bomb site, and that's where this hit is coming. That Molotov could have been great onto Shroud, but it fizzles in the smoke, just barely catching the corner of that. They drop another smoke over onto the truck side. Shroud's going to be able to find one with the Desert Eagle, trying to push through. His Freakazoid, he's not going to be able to find it. Imsta takes him down, but Shroud with the Desert Eagle is going to be able to find another one, and that leaves it all on Polly and Imsta. Woo! And we'll see if they can do anything here. And Freakazoid, or pardon me, Shroud with that Desert Eagle still trying to do some damage. That bomb is working its way up towards truck side. And they've got a good crossfire in here, Skadoodle. Gonna be able to... Oh, wow, Polly, though. Able to find two of them, and Sean Garris, the last man standing in 1v2. Well, now, we saw him clutch out a nice 1v2 there on the terrorist side. Can he do it now on the CT side? They've got one critically injured. That's Polly with only 21. He gives away his position. And he does manage to take him down, but not going to be able to find the frag. Imsta gets the better of him. So, a costly round there for mouseSpaz. They do get the bomb down, so the money's in the bank, but... Not bad from C9.
Yeah, good eco round, and they're gonna buy up here. They look like they're considering it. Sean, not a great economy. He's forced into a Famas, but the rest of them can buy up. It is critical to note, though, one kit only on Shrouds. Skadoodle's got his AWP, so putting some emphasis, and this is where they're gonna do that triple push out towards B, and they might just leave Skadoodle there with the off to just, you know, lock it down like he used to do on iMap Power. So we'll see how they decide to play that one.
Absolutely. So full gun round coming at you. FAMAS in hand for Sean Garris and Polly getting aggressive up mid, but Shroud answers back with two, and it's a 2-for-2 trade now as Zek is able to find that AK-47 headshot onto him. They're trying to open up this A bomb site, and that's going to leave Sean Garris all by his lonesome over here as that rotation is going to be coming in, but it's going to be a little bit slow, and he actually smokes off his teammate at Arches. Now he's going to have to be looking for this one. Imsta up there in the apartments just biding his time. He pulls out an 8, and Sean Garris is going to capitalize on that one, doing a little bit of damage to him.
Yeah, but Sean's still in a tough spot. The only player in the bomb site, it's going to have to be some help from Freakazoid. He's going to lob out a Molly. Sean gets one kill. Can't get a second one, but the Molly's going to stop the plant. Freakazoid's able to spray one more down, so it is going to be a one-on-one. Skadoodle's the last one left alive. No kit in his hands. And Shroud did drop that kit, I believe, up towards porch side, so...
Yeah, but so slow to go and grab that bomb. Imsta, 35 seconds still, but Skadoodle, he's playing this one smart. He picks up the M4 as opposed to going for his... trusty AWP, and now Imsta's going to go for this bomb plant. Default plant spot. Bomb has been planted. And now Skadoodle trying to make it happen again. He clutched out a 1v2 earlier with an ace. Peeking around the corner, and he gets it. Another 1v1 clutch for him. And that's going to be Cloud9 on 14.
Yeah, smart one-on-one by Skadoodle. Once he heard the plant go down, he rushed to grab the angle to make sure he couldn't fall away from the default plant spot. Comes up along that wall and then takes that angle quickly, uses that peeker's advantage very, very well, wins it out. So Skadoodle coming up huge, even manages to put his Nikes on and go pick up that AWP once more before the round's ended.
All right, so we're going to see some rebuys here from the C9 side. And even though they won that round, that economy is very, very low. So this is a good opportunity for mouseSpaz. They've got him on the ropes a little bit here with that economy. They do manage to pick up a couple of FAMASs and some rifles to boot. And they're going to go for full aggression down through mid. Those nades! We talk about the early opening damage, and again, Sean Garris going to get very aggressive down mid. Polly is going to be able to pick that up, so it is a one-for-one trade thus far, but nothing with the nade down mid. And they gathered a lot of information from Sean pushing down mid, too.
Yeah, all in all, mouseSpaz handled that really, really well, getting a one-for-one trade out of it. Sean, once he was committed to that push, he had nowhere to go. He really had to get aggressive and take a fight somewhere, and they punished him for it, so... Now it's going to be a 4-on-4, and the defense is split up 2-and-2, so this is going to be a 4-on-2 over towards the B bomb site.
Oh, man, that skin from Shroud. StatTrak Hyper Beast. I like it. But they are going to be walking right in here, and Shroud, with him crouching back behind the barrels, not going to be able to spot anything just yet, but there's the spray down, the recoil control, and Freakazoid and Shroud completely shutting down this B bomb site. Shroud popping the shots, he's falling back, and not a bad play from him. Biding his time a little while longer, demise in a 1v3.
Yeah, trying to spray through, not working out too well. Shroud's going to say I'm right back, so a fantastic run from Shroud, and even Freakazoid getting that opening kill, so... Nice hold on B, and we said beforehand that recently that B bomb site has looked like a little bit of a weakness on the defensive side for Cloud9, and Shroud and Freakazoid there, putting on a clinic, holding it down strong.
Yeah, Shroud, he stayed crouched for so long behind spools, I thought that they were going to be able to get in and get on him, but I guess it was the old bait and switch, Freakazoid going for the first point of contention, and then Shroud being there to back him up, and that's exactly what happened, and they got three kills out of it anyway. So Skadoodle going to go for an aggressive push towards mid, and Gonna be a tough stand for him there, but look at the aggression coming from the CTs down banana right now. Sean Garris looking with that Hyper Beast, but nothing is going to draw first blood this round. Shroud throws out an aid, not going to be able to find a whole lot of damage with that one right now, but all four of the remaining terrorists are all the way in alt mid, and Sean Garris is pushed down mid, but they find him. They do take him down. Freakazoid's going to be able to chime in with another one, make that two, looking for a third, not going to be able to find it. Demise takes him down, so it's a two on three, make that a two on two. Fruit finds one. So not a bad start to this round here. It was a bit of an eco round there from the mouseSpaz side. They picked up a couple of rifles as well. So definitely a salvageable round right now for them as they're looking to stave off map point. This is really going to be on Skadoodle, that AWP from Pit. He's got both members working their way up through apartments right now, Fruit and Demise. Looks like they're going to opt to go towards Boiler Room. Well, they're going to split it off here, and I don't think that this is going to be the smartest decision for them right now. Splitting their offense.
I don't think they know they're going to be going against Skadoodle with an op and Pit, although he has his 5-7 up, but yeah, this is a situation where they'll need to get the trade kill really, really quickly if they lose one, and he's going to catch Demise looking the wrong way. That gives him plenty of time to adjust. Now here's the footstep. He looks up towards Fruit. Fruit's got to find the kill. Skadoodle just buying time. 10 seconds left on the clock, and he's going to peek out delayed a little bit longer. His teammate's coming in for backup. He's going to let this plant go down. He's just going to delay it. He's going to keep delaying it. Now the plant, now he can't win. Fruit can't win no matter what happens. So that's going to be a default win. Nicely played by Skadoodle. We talked about Cloud9 needing to upgrade their players in terms of late round situations and clutch.